What's going on, guys? Chabay Agent Bagen for another Outer Plane video. And for today, it's time to update my definitive PvP tier list since we have a new season league in Arena right now. And some of you might be wondering who are the best characters in PvP. Take note that tier lists are pretty much objective. It varies from person to person. You may agree or disagree with me and it's fine. So just take it with a big grain of salt. So let us go ahead and do it on the chair maker. I'll save you the trouble of putting the trash characters, all of the 1-star and 2-star natural base characters here in the trash chair. They just don't work well in arena in PvP. That is why I just put them here in the trash category. So chairings are God Chair, the most OP broken characters in arena. Great picks, they are great characters to be used in today's current meta. Niche, they might find some maybe only one type of play style, something like that. I will be putting them here in the niche category. And then we have here PBE chair, which means that those characters are just meant for PBE and not really meant for PvP, but they are really really good in PBE. Okay, top of the top, we have Air. Air is PvE. Is there anyone using Air in PvP? I don't think so. I don't think, especially in the top of the rankings, I don't think people uses Air even in their arena opens. Air is just not built for arena, in my honest opinion. Her kit is just meant for PBE, but she's very very OP in PBE, mind you guys. So I will be putting her there. Next we have Akari. Akari is either a great pick or a niche pick. Why it's the two? One, she could be great if the opponent does not have immunity set. Her main role in PvP is debuffing the enemy with unbuffable debuff, but if the enemy has an immunity, she's already get cock blocked by that one. So I'm going to be putting Akari here in the niche chair because of her usage. Her usage is very niche, but if her niche works, she's good. Yeah, she's good. We have Alice. Alice is still a great pick in my honest opinion. Still very very underrated. If you don't have a 6-star Demi Blada, she can be your 6-star Demi Blada. She can strip, she can buff the unbuffable debuff, and she can she can activate the trigger effect of something like Notia or even other characters. So yes, still a great pick in my honest opinion. Maybe on the niche one. No. She's still great. She is still one of the fastest mage character. She's a really really good opener. That is why she is still a great pick in my honest opinion. She's still deadly. Especially if you are a newbie and you see Alice on arena defense, maybe Alice is weak, I'm gonna attack this guy. Then you get into some trouble when Alice pops up her thing. You might get caught off guard with Alice. Ame. Ame is a great character. Yeah. She got buff. If you don't know what buff she got, she was able to do some cleave in arena right now. If the opponent has a higher HP, around above 90%, her follow-up attack will be a cleave attack, and that one is very very strong, especially her skill tree already hit, can already one shot a lot of characters in the game. Follow it up by her skill one, then you might be in for some trouble if you fight against Ame. Not an OP gadget character, but still a really great character. Probably better than Alice here. Aste, PBE. Bet, PBE. Both of them, they are just only good in PBE in my honest opinion. Not really good in PvP. we have Charlotte. Charlotte is a great pick. Really, really great opener. Can possibly be going to Gacher, but right now we have Monad Ava. So Monad Ava cock blocks Charlotte if you don't have an immunity set on her. So yes, she's going to be only great. Why does it becomes a factor when it comes to Monad Ava? Monad Ava 6 star can preemptive seal any character that does not have immunity on them. And if you put immunity set on Charlotte, she will be a bit slower. And since she is a really good opener, you want her to be equipping speed set, right? So if you have speed set, Charlotte will get cock blocked by the seal skill, meaning she will not be able to activate her thing, the skill 2, that pushes mages priority. That what makes her really, really bonkers. But she's still a great pick here. We have Christina. Christina is great. The only tank, in my honest opinion, that is pretty much very, very viable in today's meta. Especially on arena defense. You will see the top players having Christina on their arena defense. Mainly to soak up damage. I'm not considering Demidragon as a tank. Because Demidragon is not tanking, by the way. She's dealing damage. But for Christina, she is the pure tank, in my honest opinion. Because of just her tanking ability, she's just absurd. She's very, very tanky, very, very sturdy. She can soak up the damage and let your other team members survive for you to be able to deal your combination. Yeah, still not a gadget character, but still a great, great character in arena, especially on arena defense. We have here the only 2-star that is somewhat niche, not on the trash tier. Alice is still... No, not Alice. Cindy. Cindy is still a really good opener for a budget character. Attack buff plus accuracy buff is still strong. And since she's a ranger, she's going to be very fast. So she will be your budget opener. So I'm putting her here in the niche category here. We have here Dahlia. Dahlia is still a great character. Just like Alice, both of them are still the fastest mage around in the entire game. If you have their exclusive equipment, they can outspeed any ranger except for D-Blada. Yeah, except for D-Blada. They can outspeed any ranger except D-Blada. And Dahlia as an opener is a really, really good one if the opponent does not have immunity. Yes, that is the only thing that is holding her back into being a gadget character. If the opponent has immunity set, then you cannot fully utilize her kit because her kit is freezing. And also characters like Monad Ava and then D-Stella and also the normal Stella cannot get frozen. And if you apply some debuff to your enemy and your opponent has a Monad Ava, Monad Ava will just cleanse the debuff. That is why it's holding her back to be on the god chair. But it's going to be really, really different if we are talking about RTA. But right now, we are only talking about the arena, the PvP arena. So yeah, she's only a great character here. Demi Aste. All Demiurge characters are gadget. All Demiurge characters are gadget in PvP. No questions asked. Demi Aste, the best cleaver. Has a defense penetration on her ult. She revives when she dies. And if you build her really, really fast with some really strong DPS kit, then it's really, really over. Demidragon, another Demiurge character. Gadget, all of the premium characters belongs to the Gadget. They are premium characters for a reason. Still very, very strong. Has a priority increase if you get critical hits or something like that. Can extinct a character with her skill 3. She's very sturdy also, very tanky, very annoying to fight against, especially if she is equipping the counter necklace. So yeah, very very strong, very annoying to fight against. The longer you fight her, the more you are in trouble. That is how good Demidragon is, but take note, these are considering 6 star. Yeah, considering 6 star Demidragon. Demistella, even though Demistella has kind of fallen off, still she is still a god tier in my honest opinion. Still very very strong in arena. Still very very OP. But probably on the far end side here, if your rankings of with regards to who's the best Demiurge, Demi Aste, the best in PvP, followed by Demidragon, then Distella here. Demi Blada is also very very dominant, probably here considering 6 star. Her strip debuff is just OP. Even if the enemy has a Monad Eva to cock block her skill 2 activation, that strip all buffs is already very OP in my honest opinion. And not only she's stripping the buffs, she's also hitting some really decent chunk of damage, especially if you build her with some really nice attacks. If you take a look at my Demi Blada is almost perfect. In my honest opinion, it's almost perfect because as you can see, 100 crit chance, 280 critical damage, 5k attack. I'm only lacking speed, maximum speed here with the helmet and then with the armor, with some really nice crit rate critical damage ratio here. So yes, Demi Blada is really really strong. The best Demiurge in my honest opinion. If we are talking about if we are ranking them, 6 star by the way, 6 star Demi Blada is the best one out of them all in my honest opinion. We have Diane is PBE, Drakan is PBE, Edelweiss is kind of been niche. Edelweiss is in a weird position because her class is a ranger, but she's a bit tanky. She can tank hits for the opponent, for your team, but it's a bit niche. Yeah, just niche. Eliza can also be a niche one. Even though she can function really well with Alice and with Alice, because Eliza can also strip buffs, but I'm not really sure if it's a good idea to use her. Yes, I think you need some I'm just gonna be putting her here, probably here. Yes, niche. She already got buffed before. I don't think they will ever buff her again. Bleed debuff is just not that good in my honest opinion, especially in PvP. Oh, we have Epsilon. Epsilon is niche. Why niche? In RTA, she's really great, but in regular PvP, she does not fit well in today's meta. It's very very easy to counter Epsilon right now. She will just get wrecked. Yes, the thing is, she will just get wrecked instantly if you know what you are trying to do. Very very risky character to use in arena right now, but she has her uses. That is why she is in the niche tier category. Eternal PBE, Fatal PBE. I was more optimistic before when Fatal was announced to be a really great PvP character, but sadly she does not really fit well in arena. If only her stealth is available on turn 1, maybe she will be able to deal to have some niche usage or maybe even great in the in PvP, but nah, her kit is just not really meant for PvP. Francesca, PBE. Gnosis, Dahlia, probably the most OP broken character in PvP right now. Both arena offense and defense. There's nothing to be said about this one, this character. The most premium of premium characters there is. A true limited character. Very, very strong. PBE wise, also very, very strong. Very dominant, especially in the current world boss. She's hard carrying the rankings in world boss. Her alone probably will also be carrying other in other game modes like joint challenge or something like that. In the previous joint challenge, she already hard carries that one, and in PvP she's just bonkers. We have Hanbuli. Hanbuli is niche. Not really that good anymore. Iota is great. Yeah, Iota is great. In my honest opinion, if you've seen my previous Iota comeback video, the arena showcase, Iota is really, really good, but not in the gadget category, but still a really, really great pick in today's meta. Kanon is still a, I think, Kanon is not Gadger anymore. Still a great character. Why is she not a Gadger anymore? Because G Dahlia exists. G Dahlia can really cock block Kanon really, really hard. Before, Kanon is very hard to kill. But with the addition of G Dahlia, Gnosis Dahlia in today's meta, Kanon becomes a bit weaker. The only one that can really destroy Kanon is G Dahlia. Yeah. Still annoying to fight against. Oh, we have Kappa. Kappa is niche. Why niche? She's only used against Mene. Yeah, she can one-shot Mene. So if you're having trouble fighting against someone that has a Mene on their arena defense, just use Kappa. She will destroy Mene without a sweat. That's why I will be putting her here in the niche one. There's some 2-star here. Trash. Kuro, I think is only PBE. Might be niche, but it's just PBE. Laplace, PBE. Leo, niche. If you're looking for some invincibility buff, then probably he can work well here as your invincibility buffer to survive one turn, to let your nuker survive. Like for example, you're protecting the Aste. Yeah, he can be a niche character. Roxy is just, Maxi is just PBE. Maxwell, the only 3-star to be in the trash one, the very first one. Yeah, trash. Mene is still great. Yeah, still very, very strong. Very annoying to fight against, and also has the speed imprint. Zombie girl, I think it's only PBE, not even niche. Yeah, she's not even niche, not even used in PvP. Yeah, only PBE in my honest opinion. Monad Ava. Monad Ava is broken. Yeah, gadget. No questions. Especially 6-star. Even low rarity, Monad Ava is still here. But 6-star, she's here. Just behind Gnosis Dahlia. Very, very OP character. There's no really nothing much to say about her. Very annoying to fight against. Invincibility buff, cleanse, seal skill, dual attacks with two characters. Auto revive. What the fuck is this character, man? Very, very OP. Lots of utilities in just one character. Noah is PBE. Noah is PBE chair. Nautia is still great, especially if you combine her with the Cleave. with Dying Blood, it's just that you need to gear Dotia to be able to counter the seal skill from Monad Eva. But if you're not fighting a 6-star Monad Eva, you can just equip her with your nasty PBE set. DPS set. Summer Regina is a bit niche in my honest opinion. Not really that strong in PvP. Yeah, I think she's just niche here. If you're not even probably niche. She's not probably even niche. Probably PBE only. Probably PBE chair only. Not even niche in PvP. She does not have protection like her OG counterpart. That is why I'm putting her in the PBE chair category only. If only she has the protection of her own OG counterpart, she might be great in PvP, but no. She's very, very squishy also, very easy to kill. So yeah, PBE chair only, not even good in PvP. Regina is a great character. Yeah, Regina is very, very strong. Wait, let me arrange this one. I think this one goes here behind Cannon. I think this one has more usage like this one. Yeah, like this. Regina has some form of self protection against nukes like Cannon and G. Dahlia. Also, she can one shot a lot of tanky characters. Both strong in PBE, in arena offense, in arena defense. She's still a great character, not in Gadger, but still a really great, great character. Rona, trash. Yeah, trash. Rin is niche. Yeah, niche. Is Rin good anymore in PBP? I don't think Rin is good anymore in PBP. Let's just put Rin in the PBE category here. Rin has already fallen up. Rin has fallen up from being one of the top tier cleavers during her launch. Now she's just sitting on the bench. Yeah, PBE maybe just giving some support in the world boss in the CP category. We have the newest character, Roxy. Roxy is great. Yeah, Roxy, I will consider putting Roxy here in the great category here. Very, very strong mage character. I'm really glad that Roxy is a really good PBP character. Not unlike her sister, which is only meant for PBE. Roxy is meant for PvP in my honest opinion. Very strong shock debuff and also very strong cleave attacks. Very, very nice. I forgot her name. Fuck. PBE. Trash. Sigma. Trash. She does not have any usage in arena anymore. So I will be putting normal Stella here in the PBE chair only. Yeah, but she's still very strong in PBE. Not in PBP anymore. In today's meta, she's not really that used. Steropi, PBE. I will be putting her in the PBE. Tamamo, PBE. One of the strongest PBE characters in the entire game. Tamara is still a great pick. Yeah, Tamara is still a great opener. Especially if you know that your opponent does not have immunity set, just slap in Tamara, then it's going to be GG for the opponent. Yeah, the only one that's holding back Tamara is the immunity set. But still, and also she's not the fastest character anymore because we have Demi Blada. If she gets cock blocked by a really strong Demi Blada, it's over for you. That's why she's only at the great chair here. Valentine still a great opener, but I'm just gonna be... No, she's still great. She's still a great opener. Yeah, still great opener. and also a priority pusher. Veronica, I'm just gonna be putting Veronica here in the PBE, not even used in the niche chair category. And lastly, normal Blada. Blada is PBE only, not really meant for PvP. And there you go, guys. This is my updated definitive PvP chair list, Roxy edition. We only have 6 god chair character that I can consider, and all of them are premium characters. They are premium characters for a reason, and they deserve the god chair in my honest opinion. Well, there you go. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And I think that's it for me for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe. I would really appreciate it if you could help me grow my channel more. And thank you to everyone who are supporting my channel. I appreciate every one of you. Until next time, peace.